Well, everyone, the iPhone 14 has came out not too long ago, so let's go and compare it against a phone that came out quite a bit of time ago, which is the Samsung Galaxy S21. Now, both these phones are very interesting. The S21 came out in 2021, the iPhone 14 came out in 2022, but it's honestly very interesting to me how both of these phones kind of compare to one another. If you want to pick them up, links will be down in the description. You can get them from there. You can help support the channel at the same time. Now, side by side, you can definitely tell there are some very interesting differences, but there's also a few similarities. The Samsung Galaxy S22 had a 6.2-inch dynamic AMOLED display on the front. Now, personally, I think this was a really good panel. It was 1080p, so I wasn't the biggest fan of that at the time, but I've grown into it since. But also, this is a 120Hz display. So this is something I really do like, having 120Hz on a phone, especially on, you know, Android, which, you know, can have some stutters here and there, definitely helps improve the experience. And I love this phone, I love this display, and I'm definitely a fan of the display. I definitely don't think it's a bad issue at all. It's a hole punch display too, with the fingerprint sensor in the display. With the iPhone 14, we have the same good old, you know, display they never want to change, 6.1-inch Super Retina XDR OLED panel. It's a very, very good panel. It gets very bright, and I definitely do think this is a really good display. The things that I'm not really a super huge fan of is it's still 60Hz, so they haven't switched away from that, you know, 60Hz yet. We still have a notch up top, which I feel like Apple could, you know, remove. I feel like that could, you know, they could remove at this point. And otherwise, though, $800 phone, I think the display is still fine. But I do feel like the Galaxy S20 of last year kind of did a better job for what it had, if I'm being honest. Now, another big thing is actually with the rest of the phone. So we do have our sides, which, you know, both phones are kind of thick. I don't think both of them are thin by any means, but they're not like super, super thick either, to be honest. They both have, you know, the iPhone 14 definitely has more of a flat side. The S21 had like a flat side, then it kind of curved at the end. It's kind of interesting. And on the bottom, USB-C with a SIM card tray on the S21. The iPhone 14 has that lightning port. Speaker set on the bottom as well. And on the back, a very, very interesting setup on the Galaxy S21. So on the S21, we had a triple camera setup, iPhone 14 dual camera setup, which was great. But the Galaxy S21 has a plastic back. So this was something that was very, very weird. I don't understand why they did this at the time. I still barely understand at this point, but they basically put a plastic back on this phone, which is actually pretty insane. Now, the iPhone 14 has this glass back, which feels and looks very, very good. So I'm a fan of the way the iPhone 14 is. I would definitely say the iPhone 14 back is way better. I do like the features that the S21 has, though. I mean, it has reverse charging, reverse wireless charging. You know, it has Samsung DeX, which is really nice, through the USB-C ports. And this phone has a lot more features, I would say, at its core than the iPhone 14. But this design was just not... The design looks good, but I'm just not a fan of the way, you know, Samsung kind of approached it, to be honest, at the time. They've since fixed it, but still, it was kind of a strange thing. So when it kind of comes down to it, I think the iPhone 14 probably is the better and more premium feeling one in the hand, but I think the Galaxy S21's display, you know, it looks way better in the display department, has more features built in within it as well, so it's not like the iPhone 14 is the clear winner. Now, in terms of software and longevity, I just realized the Google logo changed with the pumpkin. I will tell you, the Samsung Galaxy S21 pretty much has the highest likelihood of probably not lasting as long as the iPhone 14. I'll probably say the iPhone 14 is going to last longer, but I still think the Galaxy S21 is still going to be supported for a long period of time. You know, as I mentioned before, this phone doesn't really seem like it's going anywhere. And I will say this phone probably has at least like another 2 years ahead of it. And when I say 2 years, I mean 3 years. I feel like this phone really isn't going anywhere anytime soon. It's only really gotten like one or two major versions of Android. And I feel like Samsung in the next year or two could probably end up supporting this phone even longer. Who knows? You know, they've done it before. They could end up doing it again. Apple has been doing the opposite for their iPhone lineup. Their iPads they've been supporting for a long period of time, and their iPhones too. But they've been kind of grouping phones together now, which I'm not really a fan of. Like the 6S and 7 got discontinued. So I feel like, you know, personally, the same thing could be ending up happening on these devices, but I guess we're going to see what happens in the future. Now let's go do a speed comparison between both these phones. The iPhone 14 has that Apple A15 Bionic chip inside of it with 6 GB of RAM, but the Galaxy S21 has that Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 chipset inside of it with 8 GB of RAM. So let's go see which one's the faster one between both. Okay, there we go. All the apps are clear on the background, so let us get into it. Phone calls, 3, 2, 1. Okay, about the same thing happening out of here. Let's get into their app store, 3, 2, 1. Now, I did open up the Play Store here earlier, if you remember the video. So that could lead to it being faster, but the Play Store is just normally really fast. Now, one thing to keep in my opinion, look how much smoother the iPhone 14 is over the S21. You can see it is kind of glitching up, but it seems like it's still very fast on the S21. So hopping out of this one, let's go get into camera, 3, 2, 1. Okay, let's go and take a photo, 3, 2, 1. And let's go and open up this photo. Okay, very, very interesting. I don't think there was like a clear winner, but it was still very, very interesting between them. Let's go and open up something like Facebook, which I do not have. Let's do Stack, which I also don't have. Very, very weird. Let's do Snapchat, 3, 2, 1. About the same thing, not that big of a difference. Snake vs. Blocks, 3, 2, 1. I think the S21 was actually faster there. That was actually very, very surprising. I don't know if one glitched up, but one looked like it glitched up, so I'll let you guys kind of tell over the camera. Let's get into Stack, 3, 2, 1. So I don't know why I said we need an update, but this one did get into the ad a little bit faster there, which was very interesting. But it's weird we need an update for that. Let's go and get into Twitter, 3, 2, 1. It's weird you need an update for that, but you don't need an update for the ad, which is very interesting. Let's go and get into the next one, which is Instagram, 3, 2, 1. Now it might be logged in here. So I am, so we'll just kind of have to let this one slide. We can go and get into some of these other ones like Netflix, 3, 2, 1. There we go. S21 is faster. And we do have Genshin Impact on this phone too, 3, 2, 1. Now I will tell you from the few apps that I've tested and from the like 2 months or a month and a half I've used the iPhone 14 and for the year and a half or even longer than that, I've been using the S21. I will say the S21 is a very fast phone. The iPhone 14, it seems to me, is still a very fast phone too. But you do have to keep in mind that these chipsets within these phones came out the same year, technically. So the iPhone 14, even though it's a newer phone, has the same chipset as the iPhone from last year. So realistically speaking, it's a very interesting comparison between these two. From my opinion, I think the iPhone 14 is probably more optimized, but the S21 is still a very fast phone as well. So that covers it up there. Now in the camera department, like I mentioned before, triple camera setup on the Galaxy S21. You have a wide ultrawide telephoto lens. The iPhone 14, you only have a wide and ultrawide camera, which I think is great. 4K at 60 on the front and the back, but the Galaxy S21 does have 8K capability on the back, which is awesome. Now this type of phone, as I mentioned before, you're still getting a very good camera on the S21. It's not even 2 years old yet. This is a very good camera. You have 30x zoom, which is so unnecessary, but you have that type of capability. You also have 0.5x zoom, which is awesome. You have a bunch of settings built in. You have single take mode all the way over here. You have photo, you have video mode. You have this more option here, which has tons of features built in, which is really cool. And you also have pro mode. So you can go ahead and if you know what you're doing, you can go ahead and modify your photos even more. Now I never need to mess with this because I barely ever use this phone, but it's a really cool feature that you have within that's built in with your Samsung phone. And iPhones don't really have this. I wish they did. It's what it is. But with the iPhone 14, still a very good camera as well. So this type of phone, you're getting a solid sensor for sure. I mean, this phone has it all. 0.5x zoom, but only 5x zoom zooming in. I guess you could still crop photos down and everything, but it's really nice to have that type of feature built in within your phone. Even though this one doesn't have a telephoto lens, it still would have been nice to have a little bit more zoom. You have video mode with action mode. You have cinematic mode on this phone too, which is really cool. Slow mode and time lapse and all these other things, portrait mode as well. I still think the Galaxy S21's camera is really good, and I feel like Samsung did a great job with that phone last year. I think the iPhone 14 photos, much like the performance, like the photos are more optimized and they look better most of the time. But I still think the Galaxy S21 did a great job with its camera, and I do think it's probably better in some ways. Like, I don't think the iPhone 14 is like the clear winner. I think the S21 did a great job when it came out as well. So in terms of that, that kind of covers it up. And to be honest, I think the iPhone 14 is a tremendous phone. I just think it's kind of overpriced. You can buy an S21 nowadays for like not even, probably like $300, probably even less than that. So it kind of makes not more sense to buy that phone, but it seems like this is a way better deal on this side of the option than on something like the iPhone 14. I feel like for $800, it's so overpriced. But for the Galaxy S21, I think this one is a really decent option. If you're wanting a cheap phone or even a cheaper phone than the iPhone 14, then this one has a very similar type of experience and it's better in some ways as well. In most ways, I would be honest. So in terms of that, that kind of covers it up. If you have any other thoughts or questions, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, not me so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.